the bottom of your pot with some Fritos. Now you're gonna take a 38-ounce can of chili with beans, and you're gonna pour that over the top of our Frito. There we go. And then you're gonna spread that out, covering all of the chips. You're gonna take a 10-ounce can of Rotel tomatoes with green chilies. Let me just flatten that out. Now you're gonna take some of your shredded cheese. I'm using the reduced fat Fiesta blend kind. Cover the top with that. And you can just spread that out with your hand. You don't have to use too much right now because we're gonna add more. But on top of the cheese, we need some sour cream.
Sour cream?
Yep, it's in the top shelf.
I can get that. Right here, oh, here it is. Sour cream, light sour cream.
We've used the light reduced fat cheese and we're using the light reduced fat sour cream because every little bit counts, right? Or do y'all think I'm crazy for doing that? Take your sour cream.
I think you're crazy, but for other reasons.
You're gonna add the entire container of sour cream on top. It's okay if it's a nice thick layer. You're gonna use your spoon to just spread that out. Kind of pressing down. There we go. You just want to kind of cover all of that cheese. But y'all tell me that I'm always stingy with the cheese. So we're going to top it with another layer of cheese right now. Now you could use fresh cheese and then shred it yourself if you prefer to do that. Some of y'all tell me you'd rather shred your own. Let me know in the comments. Do you want to do that? Or do you like the ease of just having the bagged cheese?
Who shreds their own cheese?
Some people really do.
Really?
And same goes for the chili. If you want to make it from scratch, you go right ahead. I'm just showing you the quick and easy version. I'm going to top that with a few more of these chips. And that's it, y'all. We've got a chili cheese Frito casserole. Super easy, super delicious. Bake this on high for 2 hours, and then it's time to taste test.
Can't wait.
All right, y'all, our chili cheese casserole in the crock pot is ready. This one's super easy. Look at that. We already know this is gonna be delicious because it's got all the ingredients that you know and love. We've got our Fritos. We've got chili with beans. Do you like your chili with beans or without beans? Y'all let me know. And then we also have some cheese, some sour cream, and just because I like a little bit of a spicy kick, I use some Rotel tomatoes with the chilies.
Ooh.
I'm ready to scoop one of these out. Okay. So you're gonna go deep to the bottom because that's where you've got that first layer of Fritos. Ooh, this looks so good. All of the things that we love. Now, if you wanted to, you could take more Fritos, put them on top for the taste test because if you want it to get crunchy, you could do that. But I think I've got it. Look at this. So you got the chips on the bottom. And look, y'all, they are still crunchy. Everything is nice and melty. Kyle, you got
to
get in
here. Yeah,
and try
I'm coming
this.
In right now. I can't wait to try this one. All right, here we go.
Now, do you like beans or not? Do you like the beans?
Of course.
Don't do the beans on. They already know. You want the first bite?
Sure.
Yeah. Now, this is a recipe that I've seen online in different variations.
It's good, guys.
I added the Rotel tomatoes. Do you think that was a good addition?
I think so. I'll have another bite. Let me double check, make sure it's really good. Mm.
That's just, I think I just gave you sour cream and chips right there.
Mm-hmm.
Is it enough cheese? Was I too stingy with the cheese?
No, I'm not crazy about cheese like you know, like you are.
So I did good, perfect amount?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is so good and so easy. This is perfect for a gathering, game day, or just a lazy dinner one night. This one hits the spot.
What do you call on this one?
Chili cheese casserole.
Chili cheese casserole. Delicious. Who knew?